The Chicago Bulls have spent this season trying to find a way to improve their defense and improve their offense while also giving the young guys a chance to play. But the big star that we want to see take a jump is Matas Buzelis, the rookie for the Chicago Bulls who we've all hoped will make strides and become the next big piece of this team. So far, he has not disappointed. We're going to talk about that, but first, before that, you got to hear the intro.
Welcome to the Let's Talk Bulls podcast.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Bulls, your number one Bulls podcast in Chicago. My name is Quinton. I'm your host. And if you're new to the channel, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit that bell notification so you're notified when I drop more of these videos. With that, let's talk about Matas Buzelis. The kid is coming out with a vengeance. He is showing that he has that dog in him, okay? He's not afraid to shoot. He's not afraid to make mistakes. And the big shout out we gotta give is to, honestly, Billy Donovan. He does not take him out if he makes mistakes. He lets Matas play through the game. And that's what you want. You want him to build confidence. You want him to understand that he belongs on this team. Matas is not just some regular rookie. He's a highly touted draft pick. Not only that, he also played in the G League last year, so he has some skill. He understands what he can do on an NBA level and tier of player, and that's something that we don't always get on your team. You have to help that blossom. And when I say this kid is ready for the NBA, I am not lying. So let's just talk about his last game against the Nets. Okay, this kid is showing he is ready. This is him right here shooting the three from the corner. He is not afraid to shoot a shot at all. He pulls up when he's open, and he's an aggressive scorer. I think at this point, he's like the top two in the team with dunks. He already has 9 so far, and he's barely playing. And that's because he attacks the rim with a vengeance. He doesn't hesitate to go after people. And not only that, when he does make a mistake, he cools down and then he takes another shot. He doesn't just fade away like Patrick Williams, right? This kid has a confidence that we've been waiting for the Chicago Bulls. He plays consistently, and as he keeps playing, he's going to get better. I can see Matas Buzelis putting on a good amount of weight over the offseason and becoming a bona fide attacking type of player towards the rim. Now, personally, I think Matas should be a small forward. I say you put Matas as small forward, you keep Patrick Williams at power forward, and then eventually once we move on from Vooch, you're going to have Jalen Smith at the center. You're going to have a young, dynamic team. And you also know there's going to be probably a big move this season to try to get some type of star veteran player. That is what we are hearing from people who are around the Chicago Bulls. So the goal here is to try to get your young players time. Try to keep Matas playing consistently and learning what he can do. Because it's more than just confidence. It's also learning how to play certain players. It's learning how to attack certain times. And that's a skill in itself. One thing I will say Matas has that most players don't have is that he knows how to cut to the basket if he's off ball. And that's something that the Bulls struggle with a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean a substantial amount. They are not good at driving when they are off the ball. And that's something that I think Matas is going to continue to get better at. I think he's going to become a great player for this team. I think he's going to become one of the stars of this team. But the couple things I do want to see him work on is, one, his handle. I think Matas can dribble, but I think that can improve. We've seen Kobe White and what him going to Johnny Dribble too much has done for his confidence handling the rock, and also what he can do on the court. And I definitely think Matas has to keep working on that in the offseason. It's not going to happen right now, but during the next couple years, I hope to see him keep working and starting to get a handle that is not only something that gives him more and more ability to get to the rim, but also the ability to get through and pass up a lot of defenders who won't be ready for his quickness. Another thing I also want him to continue to work on is his shooting. He's doing that right now, but I think it can get even better. You can see he has really good form when he shoots, and him working with Peter Patton already is showing a lot of improvement on just what his form looks like. So I can't wait to see what that continues to do as he works on it year after year. I think he's going to be great. I think Matas is a player who's not afraid to put in the work. He's already grinding as hard as he can to try to grow, to get better, ask questions, do what it takes to be an elite talent in this league. Now, will he become a mega superstar? Probably not. But I do think Matas can become an actual superstar on this team. And for me, superstar means a player who is household named. Everyone knows who he is. He's one of the key pieces to this team, maybe a top two, top three player on this team who goes out, gets buckets, plays defense, and has a couple all-star appearances throughout the first 5 to 6 years of his career. Now, does that mean he's going to be the number one? No. I think there's going to be somebody else who we get who takes over that spot. We also got a couple draft picks that are going to be in the next few years that might be able to do even better than Matas. I especially think this following year coming up, if we get really good pick this year in the top two or three and we get to keep our pick, there's a chance we get Ace Bailey. There's a chance we get Cooper. I don't think I want Cooper, but I'm not going to say no to a great talent. You never know what you're going to see, and or maybe the Bulls trade and find a superstar that way. But I don't see Matas being our number one. I see him being a great number two to three on this team, and also see him being one of our better defenders. The more I watch him, the more he's starting to attack people on the defensive end. I can see he has a key for it. He can block shots. He tries to help out on defense, which is something you can't say for a lot of players, yet alone rookies. So I believe if he continues to keep going, gaining this confidence, understanding what his body can do, and understanding what type of game this team needs, I could see Matas having the highest ceiling out of all the players on the Chicago Bulls right now. This kid is going to be something special. What I want to do, though, is I wanted to make a quick video about Matas. I want to hear your thoughts. So please comment below. Let me know what you're thinking about Matas Buzelis, how his game has gone so far already, and what you think is in store for the future. With that, I just want to thank you guys. I couldn't do this channel if it wasn't for all of you. So to my LTB Nation, I hope y'all have a great night. I'll see you next time. Peace, y'all.